It had to happen eventually. Someone has died while driving their Tesla Model S in Autopilot. In this video, we'll go over what happened and how Autopilot actually works. Tesla released a statement about an incident that happened in May where a man driving his Model S in Autopilot crashed into a semi and unfortunately died. The NHTSA has begun a preliminary investigation. The two vehicles were traveling in opposite directions down a four-lane highway in Florida. The truck driver made a left turn across the road when the Model S hit the underside of the trailer, crashed through fences, and eventually hit a power pole. Before we get into what we think might have caused the incident, here's how Tesla's Autopilot actually works. Autopilot is a few different features, and in this case, traffic-aware cruise control combined with auto steer. These features use three different sensors: a forward-facing radar, there's a camera mounted near the top of the windshield, and 12 ultrasonic sensors providing 16 feet of coverage all around the car. Many people confuse Tesla's Autopilot for fully autonomous. Fully autonomous cars do a lot more than the Tesla Model S. For instance, the traffic-aware cruise control feature keeps the car at a safe distance behind the vehicle in front of it. The maximum speed is set by the driver, not the car. And auto steer uses the car's camera to see the lane markers. No lane markers, no auto steer. It doesn't do things that a fully autonomous car would do, like look for stop signs or follow a pre-planned route. Autopilot just goes forward. That's it. From our research, Tesla heavily stresses that the driver needs to stay attentive and alert while in autopilot. The feature is disabled by default and requires the owner to actually opt in to use it.
Yeah, so I think it's important for us to differentiate autonomous driving versus autopilot. Autopilot is what they have in airplanes. For example, we use the same term that they use in airplanes, where there's still an expectation that there'll be a pilot. So if the onus is on the pilot to make sure that the autopilot is doing the right thing. We're not yet at the stage where you can go to sleep and wake up at your destination. If we would have called it autonomous instead of autopilot if that was the case.
Right.
But what we are doing is making it a lot easier and more comfortable to drive the car, and incorporating a lot of active safety features so that the car will stay in its lane, will automatically brake, will maintain a distance to other cars.
One theory for this incident is that the sensors are horizontally wide but vertically narrow. Tesla's own documentation states that it might not detect objects lower than the front fascia or hanging from the ceiling. In this case, hanging from the ceiling would be like the underside of a truck bed. At this point, with the information that we have confirmed, we don't know who exactly is at fault. Was the driver paying attention to the road as Tesla recommends? And if he wasn't, would things have been different had he been? We're not sure, and we probably won't know for a long time. But has your view of Tesla or autonomous cars been affected by this? You can let us know right here in our poll, or talk about it in the comments below. On YouTube, be sure to subscribe and thumbs up. On Facebook, sad emoji, and share it with all your friends. Until next time, I'm Ken with 4 Wheel Online, and you've just been refreshed.